Let's look at a lay person who is walking on the street and is keen to put his money for investment. How will he choose an appropriate product? The first step is to, as an investor, understand what you want to save for, what you want to invest for, what is your objective. So if my objective is to buy a car after 5 years, or I'm saving for a big deposit in a house, or for buying a house, or it's for retirement. There are so many products out there in the market, and it's extremely difficult to choose unless if you actually know this language that we are in. My advice is that go to your financial advisor and tell him exactly what you want to save for. That financial advisor will use his tools to first of all try and find out what your appetite towards risk is. So he will ask you a couple of questions, but those questions will then be converted into a risk spectrum. From there, after asking you all those questions, you will be able to tell whether you are risk averse or you can actually take risk. And then from there, then he will interpret your objective, put it into investment language, and then he can determine whether you want something that is it's got 6+1 or 6+2 or 6+3. 6 being an index that tracks your equity performance over time, or he can actually determine that, look, due to inflation, you have to be targeting this particular inflation because of your need. So from there, once he knows that you're targeting a CPI plus 3, there are portfolios. Most asset managers do have portfolios that target inflation-related objectives. For example, you'll find a CPI plus 3, you'll find a CPI plus 4, and most of these funds will be absolute return funds, implying that they've got dual objectives. They are chasing CPI plus over a long-term period, but then over a short-term period, they are protecting your downside. He will have to choose on that, depending on how you ranked on the risk measure. Then you will be able to choose an appropriate portfolio. Make sure that then every now and again, maybe my advice is that every year you actually relook at your portfolio and see how it's doing over time. Some portfolios, they will say that they protect on the downside, but you may find that that's not the reality. And if you're going for a balanced portfolio, you may find out that depending on the amount that you want to invest, you may want to go for unit trust, you may want to go directly to an asset manager. That means you've got some millions of. One other alternative is to go to a multi-manager who will actually mix or blend different asset managers, such that then you are protected. You've got not only asset diversification, but you also have manager diversification, and you get the best of breed of managers managing your money.